is King of Glory, that pursues me with his love, and haunts me with each hearing of his softly spoken words. And my conscience a reminder of forgiveness that
appreciate most about Neil is just that he really has a heart to serve God, and he really he's always serving, he's always leading worship or leading our small group or helping out, and it's really awesome. I've been really blessed to be in a small group this year. I think especially during winter quarter when I had a lot of drama in my life that I think I called him up like twice every week just so we can meet up so I could confess all my problems, and like and then he really comforted me and really gave me a lot of advice. Just awesome that he would take his time to meet my needs.
Appreciate most about Martin.
I appreciate Martin bringing me to this ministry.
I appreciate that he's a cool guy to hang around, and also I appreciate he's encouraging when we do meetups that I can just talk with him and about like the problems I have, and he can encourage me and just help me through them.
Appreciate Vivian. Can't think of anything. No, I'm just kidding. I really like Vivian's upbeat energy because she's like really awesome and smiles a lot and seems to never like be stressed down, even though I'm sure she's like really does a lot of midterms and tests, and yeah, I never see her like really bogged down with stuff. And then whenever I'm around her, she'll like giggle and then smile, and it's just really cool, like really cheer me up. And I really like her as a small group leader because sometimes she'll bake us stuff, and yeah, her upbeat energy is something I would truly miss.
Tom,
what do you most appreciate about Travis?
I think I most appreciate that Travis is honest. He never shrinks back or tries to hide what he's really thinking. And that's really a blessing because I know that he's not trying to put up a front. And he's genuine, he's real, and the best part is he's willing to change.
What I appreciate about Nora the most is that she's very genuine and open and honest in what she shares.
She's also very welcoming and just a pleasant sister to be around. She's really encouraging by just like her gentleness and her smiles.
Yeah, one thing I really appreciate about Hiroshi is his effort. Yeah, one time I saw him at the end of rally where he just came after his one of his club. It really surprised me because, you know, it's end of rally and, you know, everybody's saying goodbye to each other. There's no really point of coming, but Hiroshi was like, you know, I want to. So he made his effort to come. It really surprised me. Really. And the other thing I really appreciate about Hiroshi is that him just being my disciple. Yeah, just teaching him a lot of stuff makes me learn too. You know, it encourages me to. Yeah, be more spiritual, be more devoted to God, not just to improve my relationship with God, but also for Him too. I think it improves both of us. So that's why I'm so appreciative.
I like how he talks about mango with me. We're both kind of lame like that.
I think the thing I appreciate the most is her first name, because I just really think that it just sounds really nice, you know? And I think that people called Stephanie are just naturally sweet. So I think, yeah, definitely the thing I appreciate the most is how sweet she is and her personality, because it really brings a lot of joy to my life and it's very unique. So that's what I appreciate the most.
I love the way that he's just really honest, you know, really easy to get along with, and he's very sensitive to like spirit and stuff, and you know, just to see if everybody's, you know, doing okay, and just really easy to buddy up with. And you know, I'm always really encouraged because he always comes out to basketball and just hangs out with us, you know. And I think that what I can learn from him is that, you know, to have that very childlike spirit, to be, you know, innocent in Christ, and really just to not have any pretenses and not put up a facade, because, you know, for Matt, I think what you see is what you get, and that's what I really appreciate and love about him. And you know, I just hope that everything goes well for him in the future, and that, you know, God be with him.
What do you appreciate most about Martin?
I think Martin's a really dedicated person. Yeah, that's, I said dedicated. And I also think he's he pretends to be I think he pretends to be a bus, but he's actually a very, very honest and very very caring person. And yeah, Martin's a cool guy.
Something I appreciate about Jesse, Dane, here, thanks, is that aside from being my brother, he's also been my best friend after knowing him for all my life and living with him for a long time. He's been able to see me when I'm not having my good days, and he's seen the ugliest side of me, I think, after getting to a lot of fights and arguments with him. Yeah, he's definitely seen that side, but I'm just really grateful that he's still my best friend and still accepting. And that kind of just shows me how, God still accepts us even though we sin and everything. So I'm really thankful that my brother has that in him, you know, and just always supported me through life when I made mistakes, and still encouraged me to keep going and persevering. So I'm really thankful for that. And you're my best friend by choice, but my brother by fate.
I appreciate discipling Darcy the past couple years, and he's definitely grown a lot and broken out of some of his shyness, and I appreciate just living with him this past year. He served a lot in small ways, like behind the scenes, that a lot of times I didn't notice but I saw later, and so I really appreciate him as a roommate and sticking by me, and very teachable guy. He learned a lot and he grew a lot this year. I think God blessed him for his being a fat disciple.
Hey Kenny, this is Jason. So I wanted to share a few things about you. One thing I appreciate about you is, I'm thinking back to when we first met a couple summers ago. I remember that at the time you weren't a Christian, but you were very persistent about the questions that you had, that you had on your heart, and that you wanted to know about God. And I just really appreciated your questions and the sincerity with which you were seeking. And so that's something I appreciate about you. And I think it's something that has kind of shown itself since then. So I'd encourage you just to kind of continue in that way, and seek God. Even though you're a Christian now, and God has definitely done something genuine and authentic in your life, continue to seek God in the same way. So I wish you the best, and stay in touch. So that's all.
Go light your world.